Hi there, welcome. My name is Sally Almasraf. I am a solutions engineer here at QBuild Software. Before we start delving into the demo, we're excited to introduce you to QBuild. We're the industry leader in integrating engineering software to ERP by providing customer-centric services to over 2,000 discrete manufacturers. We're very proud to be partnered with over 50 engineering and ERP solutions. We are an international company with offices all around the globe, and that really allows us to stay connected to our customers in various different time zones. QSuite is our comprehensive solution suite, which includes CADLink, ECX Manager, NestLink, and more. And we empower our customers by streamlining processes and providing significant cost savings, all while ensuring efficiency and accuracy every step of the way. Now today, we're going to be demoing CADLink for SOLIDWORKS PDM Professional to Oracle ERPs. Before we get started, let's take a quick overview of a workflow without the use of CADLink. So as you can see from this process chart, manual data input is very time consuming and it often results in a lot of errors. Now, with CADLink, you can see that this process improves the accuracy while reducing the time spent to create or update items and bills and materials in your Oracle ERP system. And all of this is done with just a click of a button. So with that being said, let's jump into the demo. Today, again, what I'm going to be showing you is a demonstration of CADLink integrating between SOLIDWORKS PDM Professional and Oracle ERP systems. So let's go ahead and get started. CADLink is a tool that's designed for the engineers and the CAD users. And as such, it is an add-in that sits directly in your CAD or PDM. So I've got my PDM Professional opened up here through my File Explorer. And in order to initiate the CADLink launch, all I have to do is navigate to the file that I'd like to launch CADLink with, right-click, and simply click on my CADLink button. Now, what CADLink is doing at this point in time is it's comparing all of the items and bill of material data between my PDM items and BOMs versus my Oracle ERP system. And it's doing this all in real time. It's giving the user a chance to validate the information and review the BOM changes prior to pushing into Oracle ERP. So the user interface here has popped up. And again, at this point in time, we have not pushed anything into Oracle yet. We're giving the user a chance to review the data first. If we start off with my left-hand side column here, so you'll notice these indentations. This is that parent-child relationship being maintained from my tree structure in SOLIDWORKS and SOLIDWORKS PDM all the way through to CADLink and your Oracle ERP system. Next, let's talk about these colors. Of course, they're a very visual representation, and at a quick glance, once you understand what these colors mean, you're able to determine exactly what kind of BOM changes are taking place. So if we start off with my white items, assembly 10, for example, here, this is an item that already exists in my Oracle ERP system. It matches with the information coming in from PDM. And so the data on both sides is completely in sync for these white items. Now, taking a look at these yellow highlights, so whether it's my quantity or my description or perhaps my revision highlighted in yellow, this is a field level discrepancy. By right-clicking on the field, you're able to see what the discrepancy is and what the difference is between your CAD or PDM system and your ERP. In my case here, I've got the space in between my words cartridge and heater. That space is not present in my Oracle ERP system description for this item. And because CADLink is bidirectional, you are able to select one of these descriptions and write them both in the direction of the Oracle ERP system, as well as back into your PDM. So in my case here, I'm going to choose my ERP description. Additionally, I'm going to modify it as needed in my CADLink interface And then once I hit save, this updated description will be pushed into Oracle and also updated back into my PDM data cards. Next, we've got brand new items. So these green rows here are items that CADLink will create for you upon save. So two steps that you would otherwise have to manually perform on your own inside of the Oracle ERP system, CADLink will do all at the click of a button. It's going to create a record of these items according to the data that's being pulled in from PDM. And it's also going to insert these components into my bill of materials and bill of materials revisions. Next, these gray items are items that are to be omitted from my bill of material in Oracle simply because they are not found in my PDM BOM. So this can be due to a few reasons. Maybe this item has become obsolete, or maybe due to a design change, I've decided to replace it with a different component or a different subassembly. Regardless, we are now going to remove this item from my latest bill of materials revision in Oracle in order to match that updated design. Now, please do note that this is not an item that's going to be removed from your item master, because it may still be used under different assemblies, or it may have different transactions against it. But it is going to be removed from this particular bill of material and bill of materials revision. Last color is a feature called manual parts. If I were to right click on this little white box on the left side of any of these components, I can add a manual part. And this allows me to add a component that is not necessarily modeled in PDM. So you can think of this as a consumable, perhaps a bolt, nuts, glue, paint, user manuals, and I'm able to search for an item based on its item number or its description or display name from my Oracle ERP system. A list of all the items that follow this criteria will pop up here, and I'm able to select an item that I'd like to choose. So I'm going to hit that first one. You'll notice that my item here will now be highlighted in blue, indicating that this is a manual part that I'm adding to my Oracle ERP bill of material, but it is not something that is driven by that PDM BOM. And although all of the item parameters will be pulled in based on that item in ERP, I do have to specify how many of this component do I want to add to my BOM. So in this case, I'm going to select a dozen, and moving forward, once I hit save, this item will be added to my bill of material in Oracle, although it's not something that is in my bill of material in PDM. Now, moving on to the right-hand side here, all of the ERP-specific fields, such as your units type, item source, class, are all drop-downs pulled in directly from your database. So these are not drop-downs that need to be maintained by you. They are automatically pulled in from within your configuration of your ERP system. And these are particularly important for new items. So you'll notice these green rows here, they don't yet exist in ERP. And oftentimes we need to handle some ERP data in order to create these new items. And CADLink allows you to do so by selecting from drop-down values that are pulled in from your ERP. Now, if we continue scrolling to the right-hand side here, CADLink also allows you to handle raw materials. So you'll notice for my inventory item here, I've got a raw material of steel sheets that are already defined. And this is something that can be pulled in from your PDM as well, if you've got it defined there. Alternatively, for new items, you are able to add a raw material on the fly, and again, search for an item based on your Oracle ERP system. Now, moving on to these tabs on the top right-hand corner that provide additional information that can be very useful. First of all, changes tab. This is a list of all of the bill of material changes taking place. So you can think of it as the same information that we've got on our left-hand side here, but laid out in a different format. and it can be exported to be used outside of the CADLink interface through either Excel or PDF. Through CADLink, you're also able to assign manufacturing routings for assemblies or subassemblies that are to be manufactured. So CADLink's ability to add routing steps is available, you know, directly through this interface, and you're able to assign corresponding work centers or cost templates for each of these steps, depending on how your ERP system is configured. Alternatively, you also have the option of selecting from a routing template and applying a series of routing steps here based on information that is available in your ERP system. Next, we've got our CAD data information, and this is a read-only tab that gives you insight on information that's available from within your PDM data cards. So rather than switching back and forth between PDM and CADLink, you have the ability to take a look at PDM-specific item and assembly data. Through the thumbnail image, you're also able to gather a quick visual reference of the item that you have selected as well. And finally, through CADLink's data validation tool, the messages tab is a great way to ensure that all rules and logic that need to be handled through your Oracle ERP system directly are also applied through the CADLink interface. Now, what you'll notice here is because I've got a critical error, my save button on the top left-hand corner is currently disabled. And that is done by design to ensure that any rules that need to be followed as a mandatory within your Oracle ERP also need to be handled through the CADLink interface. So the assumption here is that your CAD users or your CADLink users don't necessarily need to be experts in your Oracle ERP system space as well. So in order to rectify this error, I can simply click on it. You'll notice that the row where the error belongs will be highlighted. And at this point in time, I'm able to give it a quick read. I know that my error belongs to my BOM revision in this case. I can right click on my BOM revision, and I'll notice very quickly that I am currently selected on a previous BOM revision that is no longer active in my ERP system. And as a result, I'm going to go ahead and select the latest BOM revision so that the information that I'm updating in the ERP is the latest and greatest value that I'd like to use moving forward. Hit the word accept. You'll notice now my error message has disappeared. And at this point in time, I'm able to go ahead, click on the save button, and watch CADLink in seconds create brand new items, delete items that are no longer required in my bill of materials in manufacturing, revise any discrepancies that may currently exist between my PDM data set and my Oracle ERP system, and add any components that I don't necessarily need to model in my CAD system. All right, so I hope this was insightful. If you're ready to take your workflow to the next level, now is the time. Please schedule a demo with us today on our website to take a look at a more in-depth demo catered to your needs. Simply click the link in the description below and let's get started and start discussing how the QBuild products and CADLink can help enhance your productivity today. And that's all for today, everybody. Thank you so much for your time. I hope that you found this insightful. And please remember to like, share, and subscribe to our channel for more content. Also, don't forget to follow us on LinkedIn for more frequent updates. Thanks for watching and see you in the next one.